Some believes that the key issue is that the God is inside you.
Yeah.
And they don't need any
priest
no. any guidance. They don't need anyone to follow, just to understand that the God is somewhere. So, but and in one of your classes, you're saying that there is a kind of mirror meditation, yeah? When a person is sitting or standing in front of the mirror, looking his own eyes and trying to considering that the God is himself, trying to understand himself, to love himself, and
to appreciate oneself, at least to accept oneself.
Yes.
Yeah.
But my question is you have a master, and his name is
Yogirama. Yeah.
Yes. Then why? If according to
okay, so my actually I learned meditation and Kriya Yoga from quite number of masters, but my main Kriya Yoga master is Yogi Rama. He was born 1923 and he passed away 2006. And I published two books. Now I'm working on third book about him. Essentially, I'm writing, of course, in Russian, but now I'm planning to translate it into English and publish it in English also. And you see, you ask really very important question, because I may say yes and no. In what sense? Well, there are true masters and
false,
so not so true. Yeah, okay, false, better to say. What has been true master? The true master is just giving you techniques, certain philosophical ideas, and support you if you practice, maybe you experience some mystical experiences, you don't know what to do, and you have a master whom you may ask a question, what's happened with me, for example. And so the true master is actually empty. So the true master just comes and gives you certain keys, but you yourself open the door. The key, normally Kriya Yoga meditation quite often we call it just a key, you know, and to learn Kriya Yoga means
they
to just
show you the direction.
Direction, or just to give you a key, then okay, you may open your door
and
or not.
Explore yourself.
Yeah, yeah, but the true master never play the role of betweener between you and absolute consciousness, or if you want, you can call it God.
Not a mediator,
because
impulse.
Yeah, just that's a source of certain useful information about techniques. But false gurus, and unfortunately we have a lot of them, plenty of them, what they're doing, they just ask you to worship to them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and you become a kind of slave. And you know, now in 21st century, we're speaking about democracy, freedom, but really, okay, nobody's make you as a slave officially, legally, but it's very easy through some political or maybe religious ideology make you as a slave.
Yes, absolutely.
And you will be very happy, you may not notice that they are a slave, yeah? But what has been slavery in the 21st century? It means, okay, we take as example computers. We put some programs inside computers, and if it is a proper, good, high-quality programs, you may enjoy working on this computer. But if it is like viruses, it just destroy it. The same way, philosophy, proper or improper, it's like a programming, but for us human beings. It means if you let proper philosophy, proper teachings penetrate in your mind, then you become free, happy, and just a harmonious person. But if some viruses, mental viruses, penetrating into you, then you may become slave. But the question is that it must be your conscious choice and say, okay, this teaching I like and accept. This, no, thank you. If you will not choose, how normally we would say in a modern culture, if you will not choose, I mean, what do you want in your life, then somebody will choose for you. And
the question is how to understand that.
How understand? Very easy. You see, First of all, the true guru, for example, my root guru means the main guru, Yogi Ramaya, he was just friend. You know, the true masters, they always behave and communicate with the people just like it's a circle of friendship. The friendship, not like you have to worship to somebody. And first of all, if it's like just a friendship, plus people just practice together, they travel together, they just... There is something right about that. But if somebody is starting to play a role like a great king and you have to worship to him or her, then immediately you have to be careful, because this is a sectarian approach, not connected with meditation and Kriya Yoga. Also about right and wrong philosophy. If you take any book, any video program, any workshop, lecture, and if during this program somebody just saying to you, you know, very essential thing, you are free. From the very beginning, you are free. Nobody may let you to be free. Nobody can give you freedom, because it's just the freedom is the nature of your soul. You know, it means to be spiritual means to be free. If you are, if somebody is convincing you, okay, you know, freedom is maybe sinful, maybe you may go astray, please do not be free, please follow us. You know, it sounds nice, but really it's a tricky thing, because if you're losing freedom, you can't be a spiritual person.